you done, Espen? Espen? Stop messing around, Espen. I'm not in the mood. I mean it, Espen. Come out. Jesus, Espen. What are you doing?
Sorry. I thought I'd see if I could scare you after all.
You were getting there. Let's go inside. I don't know if I want to make you hot chocolate anymore.
I was only kidding. I'm sorry. Please, can we have hot chocolate?
Okay. But don't scare me again. And you're washing the cups.
Okay. Hey, can I go down to the pier in the morning? I want to try catch some crabs.
I'm pretty sure you're not going to find any crabs. It's a freshwater lake. Anyway, the pier's broken and dangerous. Please don't go down there by yourself.
Fine. But I still want hot chocolate.
I'm not going to pretend I was a great mother. When Espen was born, I found, to my surprise, I felt nothing. My nightmare had come true, and I was left raising a child I didn't love. My friends became distant, and Espen's father and I began to fight. I resented them both, and one day, Espen and me were alone. But as Espen got older, I slowly began to realize something. I did love him. I loved him so much I ached. He became my best friend, my favorite thing, and I lost him. We lost each other. And I don't know if I can forgive myself. Or Espen. Espen? Why didn't you wake me up? Espen? Want some breakfast? Or lunch? We have eggs and bacon. Guess he's out playing. I loved our room at the cabin. Espen's reflectors looked nice in the sunlight, and his drawings fascinated me. He soaked up the world, and it bled from his imagination to the page in pastels and pen. Espen? It's freezing. What is he doing out in this cold? Espen? I hope you're not down by the pier. I told you that thing's dangerous. Espen? Talk to me, little man. Hey! Hey! Get away from my son! Jesus! Jesus! Espen! Get away from him! Espen, I'm coming!
Hello? Hey! Is someone there?
Dropped it. I'm coming, Espen!
Espen loved his reflectors. He collected them from magazines and cereal boxes, and I bought him a couple from the gas station by our house. He'd hang them from the curtain pole at the cabin and wave his flashlight over them at night to watch them shine. I could hardly believe any of this was happening, but what I did know was the reflector I found was his. What I couldn't know at the time was that he'd left me more, a trail, and that as long as I stumbled across these reflectors now and then, that Espen was still alive.
Espen's flashlight. Go.
Espen must be cold without his jacket. When I saw Espen's jacket there on the ground, it felt like something inside me broke. I suddenly realized that this was really happening. He had been taken from me. His coat. His little coat lying in that dark place. I was his mother. I was supposed to protect him. He trusted me, and I let him down, as I had so many times before. His jacket was a symbol of my failure. I promised myself I would find him and bring him back. I just hoped that was a promise I could keep.